a cash-rich franchise and everyone wants a piece of it, from the politicians to the local businessmen. To run such a big franchise, certain rules need to be followed. And the governing council of the IPL is not ready to take any misconduct lightly. Today at Simply Chumma, we are listing down the top 10 bans which will tell you how tough and strict the IPL governing body is. Let's get on with the list. Number 10, Jadeja. Ravindra Jadeja was dubbed rock star by Rajasthan Royals coach cum captain Shane Warne when he was picked by the franchise in a draft fresh from his under-19 World Cup win for India in 2008. He played for Rajasthan Royals between 2008-2009 and performed credibly and even made his India debut meantime. But due to the sudden rise in fame, Jadeja tried to negotiate a bigger salary package with his franchise and other franchises without informing the governing body. And so he was punished by a ban for one full year in the year 2010. Number 9, Harsha Bhogle. Harsha Bhogle's contract for the IPL was terminated a week before IPL 2016 without any explanation by the BCCI. Majorly, it was said that Harsha Bhogle's remark after the ICC T20 World Cup against India versus Bangladesh, where India won by one run, Harsha Bhogle praised the Bangladesh team for their depth batting, how they had gone about chasing the 146 target. Bhogle wanted to be a fair commentator, and some backlash did come when Amitabh tweeted something which was retweeted by Dhoni. Many BCCI officials did not like that either, which eventually led to the commentators sacking in IPL 2016. Number 8, Praveen Tambe. Even at the age of 48, in the year 2019, Tambe received a bid from Kolkata Knight Riders for the 2020 season. However, BCCI put a moratorium on his participation for a strange reason. The veteran made an appearance in the T10 League in 2018 after retiring from the sport. However, he came out of retirement to play in the Mumbai T20 League and proceeded to put his name in the IPL auction. As per the regulations from the Indian Cricket Board, an active cricketer cannot participate in a foreign tournament without their permission. The BCCI had no knowledge about his withdrawal of retirement and the T10 participation, thereby ruling him out of the competition. Number 7, Harbhajan Singh. The inaugural edition of the Cash Rich League witnessed one of the most bizarre incidents when Harbhajan Singh slapped Srisant on the field. The former featured for Mumbai Indians that time while the latter belonged to Kings 11 Punjab. After the two sides clash on the field, handshakes transpired between them while the Kerala speedster copped a slap from the Punjab spinner after the former supposedly joked about MI's loss. Harbhajan received fines for his actions as well as suspensions. Along with this, BCCI also suspended him for 5 one-day internationals. Number 6, Luke Pommersbach. Pommersbach played for Kings 11 Punjab in the 2008 and 2009 IPL seasons. He then switched to RCB for the 2011 season. In 2012, he returned to play for Bangalore, but in May 2012, he was arrested and charged with molesting a woman and assaulting her fiancé after an incident at a hotel in India. IPL banned him for the rest of the tournament. He was released on bail but had to surrender his passport. The case was later settled out of court and the charges were dropped. He was then bought back by Kings 11 Punjab in 2013, but he got to play only 3 games. Number 5, Mohammad Asif. Mohammad Asif was one of the biggest draws in the inaugural IPL season in 2008. He was bought by Delhi Daredevils and proved to be an asset. However, he was banned before the IPL season of 2009 for a year after prohibited drug nandrolone was found in his urine sample, which was collected previously between a match of Delhi and Rajasthan in Mumbai. Asif was banned from the IPL for a year and lost the contract with the Daredevils subsequently. He was then caught at the Dubai airport on his way back to Pakistan with 0.24 grams of opium and was deported from the country. Number 4, Manish Pandey. Manish Pandey, India's first centurion at the IPL, was handed a 4-match ban following a complaint by the RCB that he demanded more salary than his prescribed limit from teams in 2011. Number 3, Shah Rukh Khan. Bollywood superstar and owner of Kolkata Knight Riders was banned from entering the Wankhede Stadium for 5 years in 2012. It was alleged that SRK engaged himself in an altercation with the ground staff after walking onto the ground earlier than allowed. However, the ban was overturned in 2015. At number 2, we have the Sri Lankan cricketers who were banned. In the 2013 season, due to mounting political scenario, Sri Lankan cricketers were not allowed to play or be part of the game when they played in Chennai. In light of the players' safety, the Tamil Nadu government wrote to the deciding authorities, which the council accepted. Number 1, Sanjay Manjarekar. Manjarekar has been out of commentary duties ever since his spat with Ravindra Jadeja and on-air jibe at co-commentator Harsha Bhogle, questioning his credentials as a cricketer during the pink ball test. Manjarekar labelled the India and Chennai Super Kings all-rounder a bits and pieces cricketer on social media before India's exit from the World Cup last year. This led to his ban from the BCCI commentators panelist, and he was also axed from the IPL commentator list even after the commentator apologized for his actions. Wow, IPL is pretty strict, and that's exactly why we do not show you any videos of the IPL. We hope you like this different topic. We've got some entries for the Control C contest, but we are looking for a lot more. Please feel free to record yourself enacting your favorite IPL moment. Send us your videos at simlichuma@gmail.com. The videos we show will be rewarded as well. So what are you waiting for? Press the like, share and subscribe button and go on. Make that recording and send it to us ASAP. All the best.